Because some of you have asked for a more in-depth video about my new character course, here is an overview of the course and the lessons that are available so far. It's a short but comprehensive course that goes over creating a simple stylized anime girl in Blender. You'll learn how to model the body and clothing and how to make stylized hair. By the end of the course, you'll have a textured and rigged model that you can pose or even animate. Currently, there is still a big 50% early bird discount, which will end on Sunday evening. Starting from Monday, there's a smaller discount available until the final lessons are published. So far, there's about 6 hours of content, with one more hour on the way. And future updates are free for all customers. You can choose to watch the lessons as streaming videos, which include blend files for download, as well as subtitles in French, Portuguese, Spanish, Japanese, German, and English, which is the language of the voiceover. There's also the option to ask questions under each lesson in case you get stuck. Alternatively, you can choose to download the lessons, so you can just watch them distraction-free offline. The course is aimed at beginners, and all the lessons go over the creation process of the character step by step. The difficulty is then increased gradually, so you don't get overwhelmed in the beginning. Even though it's aimed at beginners, I believe that more experienced users who have maybe already made a character or two can still pick up some interesting tips and tricks from this course. The course is made using Blender 4.5 LTS, but you can use older versions of Blender as well, as I don't use any specific features that are new since Blender 4. You also don't need any third-party add-ons to follow the course, just some free add-ons from the Blender extensions platform. It's a mix of modeling and sculpting. We don't sculpt any shapes from scratch, but rather use the sculpting tools to refine shapes that were modeled using quad topology techniques. This gives us the best of both worlds, and it's a lot easier than purely sculpting a character, while still using the benefits of the sculpting tools. In case you're curious about me, the creator of this course, my name is Jan, and over the past 7 years, I've been making free Blender tutorial content on YouTube and other social media. I like to share what I learn about Blender, and I'm always trying to become a better 3D artist. I've always wanted to create a course about characters like this, and after spending years learning about it, I now feel that I know the pitfalls and obstacles that you may face as a beginner. So let's briefly go over what's covered in the lessons. After setting up the supplied reference images and some useful Blender preferences, we look at an introduction of box modeling to create the shoes. Then we go over some different methods to create socks. Making clothing is a very important element for making characters, so it's good to know different techniques. Using some more box modeling techniques, we create the arms and legs, as well as the body. After connecting these separate parts together, we move onto the hands. Making hands may seem difficult, but using my workflow you can definitely do it. We then look at how to attach the hands. After these body parts are finished, we start on the clothing. It's important to have good underlying geometry, so before we sculpt any detail, I'll show you how to prepare the surface. Then we go over a couple of different methods for adding folds, which are of course an essential part of clothing. You will slowly be introduced to more sculpting brushes while we create more detail for the clothing, like the pockets. After that, we add some more small details to finish the clothing. I've waited until now to start modeling the character's head, because that's one of the most important parts of the model, and it might be a bit overwhelming to start with something like that in the very beginning. But fortunately, making the head is not difficult, as long as you know the techniques explored in the previous lessons. To guarantee success, we split it up into two parts. First, making a simple blockout, where we focus primarily on the shape, and then a second stage, where we focus on creating topology that's good for deformations and animation. Rather than doing the retopology in 3D, we create the topology in 2D and then project it onto the 3D surface. This makes the whole process much easier, and it then allows you to create the rest of the head topology from the blockout and finally fine-tune the shape. We then add some more geometry for the mouth, and we look briefly at how to use shape keys for facial expressions. And now it's time for perhaps the most important part of stylized anime characters, the hair. First, we explore some different tips for making hair strands and clumps of hair. Then the hair creation process is split into separate parts. This is done partially to make it more fun. In my opinion, just creating hair from curves tends to be a kind of tedious process, but also because the end result just looks better if you follow the workflow shown in this course. It's a mix of using mesh hair clumps, curves with thickness, and sculpting. Having quad topology for the hair also makes it easy to add smaller details, which greatly improve the final result. There's more lessons coming soon, and I'll do a follow-up video once all the lessons are completed. If you've always wanted to create your own stylized anime character in Blender, now is the best time to join and take advantage of the early bird discount.